Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to talk about some of the settings of the lists, how we can select a specific item of one list, how we can slice it, chop it, flatten that, and everything about it. And I have decided to go with the walls here. We are going to work on slicing different parts of this list, which is about the curves, and then to some of them we are going to assign different walls, so we're gonna have different walls on different sides of this building. So you see there's a list here. It goes from actually item number 0 to item number 7. That means there are 8 of them, and in each of these lists there is another set of lists with 4 items inside. That means the big list, which is the 8 set of lists, is responsible for each floor, and the 4 items inside is responsible for the 4 sides of the curves in that specific element. And if I click on any of these items, actually it's gonna show me which item we are talking about here. So on list number 0, it's showing the 4 actually lines in that curve. This is the first one, second one, third one, and fourth one. Okay, and if you don't want to see that thing here, you can just click here. And if you want to see all the labels, you can go with show labels. So you see in the labels, this is 0. So every label that starts with 0, that means it's part of the first list, which is part of the first floor. And then it goes from 00, 01, 02, 03. So you see that's the name of the four corners here: 00, 01, 02, 03. Okay. So let's say if I get the index number 0 here, it's going to give me the four corners of only the first floor, right? And there is an item for that. We have get item at index. So if I assign my curve to the list, because that's a list actually, and assign 0. So you see the index receives one integer. Int stands for integer. I want to double click here, put 0, assign that to my index, and I want to assign this item only to the node which is responsible to create walls. So we are going to only create walls for item number 0, which is list number 0 here, which means the four corners, that means the first floor walls will be created only. This is null because I need to run it, and then you see it shows me the first four curves that we have there. If I switch to Revit, you see that only the walls for the first floor are created. So for instance, if I go with the very last item, in this case this is 7. If I go with 7, it's going to create the walls for the very last floor here. And actually, I also should tell you something. In the last video, I made a mistake. This value that goes from there for the roof base offset, that should be negative 0.7. So that should be the negative of that code block. I want to bring another code block here. I want to say go with negative A. And that means if I assign this number here, it's going to go with the negative of that number, and it's going to assign it to my parameter name. And now it's correct. I want to run this. Okay, there we go. Okay, so now you see the roofs have the correct offset, which is negative 6, negative 0.6. And so you see that how the list works, how getting the items of one list works here. Now let's say I want to consider the first two floors, and I want to create a wall only for the first two floors. Instead of bringing the list get item at index 2 times, I want to find a better way to do that. I'll just leave that over there. How about just to keep organized, I want to create a group for this one. This will create, let's say, walls of the first floor. And this is what? This is get item at index, okay? So I'm gonna go with this color, and I mean the nodes that have this color are explaining the difference between the list items. Okay, so let's get back to our question. How can I get the first two floors? So we tried list get item at index. We can also chop and slice the list. So let's go with one. Let's go with chop. So let's see what's the difference. If I hover the mouse around the list get item at index, you see that it's going to receive only one integer. If I hover the mouse around the second one, list chop, you see that it's going to accept more than one integer. That's why you see that sign in front of integers. So if this goes here, I want to bring a code block. I want to go with 0.1, right? That means go with two items. If I assign this to my length, and if I assign this to the curves, let's see what happens. Now we have two sets of lists here. And let me see, this is not working, right? Because if you take a look, we have four set of levels here. We had three set of levels over there. That means there are too many lists within a list. That means I need to flatten this item. So I'm gonna go with flatten. This is a very useful and practical node. That goes there, that goes there. Let me run this. Okay, and I want to switch to my Revit. Now you see that only the first two floors have walls. Okay, so this was list chop. How about I group these items, and I want to say this item is responsible to create walls of the first two floors, for instance. And this is what this is. Chop or list dot chop. So you learned about another setting of the list. This, I'm gonna change this to that. So how about I go with slicing the list, which is a different thing than chop. Okay. When you slice the list, you can actually select your kind of customized items. Okay, so if I assign curve to my list, I want to say that go from item number 0, so the start would be like 0. I can go with a code block. This is gonna accept one integer. I want to say the end one is actually list number 7, so I want to assign 7, and I want to say that the step size is like 2, that means it's going to be every other list, and that goes to my curve, run, and yeah, delete that element, run. Let's see what's going on here. You see that now it created kind of the walls for the first four floors. Okay, now let me go back here. So I want to show you something different now. This time, instead of flattening the outcome here, I want to flatten the list from there, so it's going to give me the opportunity to select like the walls only on one side. Okay, now because each of these lists is responsible for one floor, it's going to be too hard to select all the walls on one side of the building, which are on top of each other. So I want to do this. I want to move this over there. I want to flatten my curves. This goes to my list, and I want to run this. I have 32 elements here. I have 32 over there too, but that was list within a list, but now they are all in one list, right? So now if I start from list number 0, so let's assign 0 to start. The end is 31, so there is 32 items. The numbers start from 0 in Dynamo, so the last item should be 31. And let's say the step size, let's go with 1. That goes to my step size. How about I go with 4? So I want to group these items. This is responsible to create walls on one side of the building and I used list dot slice for that. Change the color, there we go, and this is the outcome. Now if you want to create some walls on one of the other sides, it's very easy. We can create another item, and for this one, let me put this over there, put this over here. For this one, I just want to start from number one, and then I want to assign this to my curves. So this is gonna be creating a different set of walls. Okay, now so that one is creating walls on that side, this one is creating on this side. So now if I copy and paste this wall and assign this one to this one, that one to that one, this is responsible for one side, that one is responsible for the other side. I want to run this. And now you see that we have walls on two sides of the building. I want to do the same for the other two sides, but I want to have like more like a concrete wall or something to show you that how it works. So I want to need one more item here. Okay, and in this case, I want to go with number two. I want to copy and paste this wall item. This item goes to my curve. I want to just go with wall 200, generic 200, and then assign it to the wall type, run. And now we have glass panels on two sides and we have concrete walls on that other side. And I can do it for the last set of walls. So I want to copy and paste this item. This time this is going to be starting from 3. And I want to copy and paste these two. Curve goes to curve. And you can go with the same, or just to show you, how about I go with a 90 millimeter brick or one of these brick walls. I want to run this. Go back here. Now you see I have to put this on shaded so you can see the wall. And on the last side, I actually need to change this to 32 because it did not create the very last item. There we go. So now you see that we have glass walls over there. This wall on this side is actually a brick and metal stud. You can go with a different one if you want.